be a walking. It's been another 7 years and showing round the eyes. Another 7 years entombed in lethargy and lies. But let's dig out our old clothes and prepare for celebration. I am the son of sleep. All I need's an invitation. The heart began to putrefy, and then the body bolted. As our hair and teeth fell out, we did our best to be devoted. But let's squeeze the maggots from our flesh like tiny poison pustules. Abandon all decorum, boil us down to our essentials. We're all just carbon, water, starlight, oxygen and dreams. And the sun, the moon, the earth, the neighbours long to hear our screams. So we're back as a friend of all. Drink this cup of kindness. Just one sip, one chug, one kiss can cure us of our blindness. Heal my wanton whispers, my lips and teeth with bleeding, bleeding down among the dead men. Now you're coming up with me. were sitting in the pub drinking fruity alcohol pops from pint glasses with ice and watching the girls of summer with their bare legs and trainers and the white straplines from yesterday's top glowing across their peeling shoulders as we wait at the bar. I'm going after this. I'll head down the road, jump in the bath, attempt to shave and slash my face open as usual. Spray on the toilet water and head down the park with my big blue bag of economy cider. And I don't think I'll need my jacket. We'll kick the mess behind a tree and head down the pub to pick up the pals. But Rab will be late as usual, and when he does arrive, he'll slip in the toilets and secretly swallow. And it'll still be light outside when they flag down the disco taxis. With me silent and magpies all the way, and they'll hold it tonight. Thank you. take off, fully clothed, clamped round a girl I know on a stranger's couch, sweaty, thoughtful, needing affection. And then you wake up, and the first thing we do is make plans to get pissed. So we go to the pub and watch the girls of summer. Thank you very much, bonsoir. Cheers. It's been a very long time since we last played here. Wasn't in this venue. Has anyone seen us in Nantes before?
Yeah, that's a fucking long time ago. So pleased to meet you. Most of you must be new. Hello. This is a very old song that we probably played the last time we were here.
Sharon! Sharon!
Separate taxis and go your opposite ways, but then instantly regret it. You wonder what you missed, you wonder why you walked away, you wonder what's changed. But before you fall asleep, think about that kiss you worked so hard for, and you'll know you've done the right thing. Thank you, merci. This is a song about kebabs. Thank you. This is a religious song. It starts very quietly. Thank you very much. Back to the old songs now. The good old days. The 1990s. Fuck the 1990s. They were mostly shite, as I recall. Exactly. You know the best time? Right now, this moment, right here, right now. Can you hear what you're saying? What are you saying? Yeah, exactly, exactly, yes. That said, this is a song I wrote when I was very young. About a girl who really did not like me. Because I am a fucking arsehole. But I got over it.
Still deny it. Thank you very much. This is a song about dancing. I felt like Thank you.
dreams of ghosts. When love and dreams are sung, I've stayed many books, they are stories false and true. I cry at rock cogs, drown against the news and children's friends. The puppet movie, frozen. What would you call the opposite of a chameleon? Whatever it is, that's what I want you to be. I dreamed of touring the country, playing small intimate venues, sitting on stage in a leather wing-back armchair, and telling tales of woe. The audience would join me in a collective cry. We could all weep together as one. Find the merchandise, 100% cotton souvenir handkerchiefs, embroidered with tour dates, available in the foyer after the show. This is a song about foxes, but what it's really about is the state of the fucking United Kingdom. Not a big fan of Brexit in Scotland. One day we'll be back.
Somewhere has found their plight and presence most concerning. The headlines screamed enough's enough, but overcome with vermin. These folks have skulked around their streets, the locals live in fear. These stuffy, stringent parasites, they don't belong in here.
Thank you very much. So that was the first big weekend of the summer. It starts Thursday as usual with a canteen quiz. And as always, no one wins a big cash prize. Later I do our sound block routine by approaching Gina's new boyfriend to tell him he shouldn't feel there's any animosity between us. And then I even go and make peace with her. I shouldn't have bothered. Then on Friday night, we went to the Archies. There was only one car going, so something else had to get the train. We got through quite late and went to a pub to take the gear. There were no problems getting in. We saw the others waiting at the front of the queue, so we just slept. It was a good night. Everyone was nutted and I ended up dancing with a blonde girl who I thought had been very attractive. Until last night, Matthew informed me she had in fact been supermodel material. When the club finished, we ended up wandering the streets. And then we found this 24-hour cafe. But I fucking hated it. So we thought, let's get a taxi back to Morris. But I couldn't sleep. So we stole someone's strawberry wine and tried to keep everyone else up. morning we went downstairs to buy some booze. We had intended to watch the football in the afternoon, but we passed out by then, awakened to find that England had won 2-0. Then we went to get the train home and had a few in the station bar. We had some stuff left for the previous night's supplies. So when we got home, we decided to go to John's in the disco. Same story as Friday, lots of hugging, lots of dancing, etc. I couldn't sleep again, so we went to the park to look at the tune. We had to climb over this fence and lose our hands, legs and groins. But we had a good laugh, especially on the tube side, which probably doubles as a vehicle for drunk teens. We looked at the tune, which was disappointing, but the mist on the lake was cool. On Sunday we get to John's in time for the symptoms. It was a brilliant episode about love always ending in tragedy, except for Marge and Homer, and to tell you the truth, my eyes were a bit damp. We went up the pub about 10. It was busy for the Sunday, full of people we know, including my first ever girlfriend, who I still find very attractive. But we don't really speak anymore. But by far the highlight of the evening was watching Malcolm make some terrible attempt to chat up a girl we know called Jo. Something about a barely there strut or something. I couldn't sleep again that night, thanks to some seriously disturbing nightmares. Matthew says I should cut down on the cheese.
Lasted forever. And hi with our friend, it's official, it's summer. Waiting for the weekend, it lasted forever. And hi with our friends, yeah.
And waiting for the weekend, it lasted forever. We got hi with our friends, it's official, it's summer.
Waiting for the weekend, it lasted forever.
I got such eventually on Monday afternoon, and then late on my computer, and introduced me to the power of many doubts. £1.79 a litre, 8.2%. Just as the water came out and we sat in the garden and drank, and then Matthew came in and we thought, fuck it, let's go back up in town. And I think it's safe to say it's officially summer.
I with our friends, it's officially summer. Cheers.
Sad songs left.
Speed page! Bags of three! Speed page! The query!
Yeah,
it's kind of retired.
played cherubs in a long time, sorry. I don't think. I mean, Smiley, you can probably remember the bass line. Next time.
I hear we had a great time.
This is David Jeans on the drums, Graham Smiley on the bass, Stevie Jones at the keys, and Richie Dempsey's up the back. Someone over here said packs of three. Who was that? Was it you? This is for you. You ready?
Thank you,
it was the biggest cock you'd ever seen. But you've no idea where his cock has been. You said you were careful, you never were with me. I heard you did it four times, but Johnny's coming back, so three. She was the best shag I'd ever had. That doesn't mean I'm saying bad wives. I think you were walking. We got a hotel. We didn't have anything, but I thought, fuck it, I may as well. I never told you the rest. I was drunk and I told you I was thinking about a test. You know I just said it for effect. And you laughed and said I'd fuck anything to lose if I'm erect. And she's a famous harlot in this town. I know enough to, but I couldn't turn her down. He said I'm an asshole. What was I thinking? It's far too easy to sit there and blame it on drinking. One more song for you, then we're off. Thank you very much for coming. I'm sure we'll see you again at some point. This is our last song. There's no, I mentioned Brexit earlier, that's why there's no merchandise to sell, by the way, because it's just a fucking nightmare importing things, so sorry about that. Anyway, thank you again. This is the last song. Cheers.
This cunted stuff.
Lost my social skills a while ago, but now I feel them coming back. My eyes were rolling when we met, and now they are preparing for attack. I want to fall in love tonight, form the perfect unbreakable bond. You can be my teenage Jenny Agatha, swimming naked in a pond. You know I'm always moaning, but you jumpstart my serotonin. But how'd you know you've ever really loved?
Thank you very much.